What's your definition of biblical manhood, if I ask you that? There is a ruthless religious rant out there. And this rant basically says this: you're not praying enough. You're not a good enough husband. You got to spend more time with your wife. You're not reading your Bible enough. You're not attending church enough. You're just not a good enough father. You're not a good enough friend. You're kind of selfish, and you're a Christian, but you're not a disciple. You're just never enough. And so many Christian men walk around with the feeling that I'm not enough. I grew up as a performance guy. I got accepted in love when I made money. And I was involved in companies that we raised up millions and millions of dollars. And I learned how to live a wealthy life. Then I found out that my whole identity was tied up in my performance. And as church guys, we could take the very same scorecard that I just read you and apply it to our lives. And you know, there's one thing about us guys, we tend to love Jesus on one level and actually dislike ourselves very much on another level. And that's not what God knows your heart greater than you do. You are not to condemn yourself. You are to be free. Why? Because Christ came, what? Not to make men good, but to make men free.
Amen.
Your goal today is not to be good. It's to be in love with your Creator. It's to learn how to focus on the audience of just you and Him. Tom, if you could put that slide up. It's just you and Him. Isn't that wonderful? God did not come to make you good. You see, guys think they got to get good to get God, but they get God, then get good, if that makes sense. You see, so Christ did not come to make men good, but to make men free. And when you try to do anything else, it's called Galatianitis, if you're a Bible reading guy, when you try to do anything else, you'll get caught up in Christian performance. Is that okay?
Amen.
Yeah, yeah. The Holy Spirit will convict you, but He's always going to comfort you. He's always going to make you capable of doing the thing you're struggling with that you say, I can't help it anymore. You can. We could take your anger, your frustration, your lust, your sexual lust, your material lust. We could take all of that. And you may be right as you take that, saying, I just can't do it. I'm out of control. I can't control these things. That's great. Today we're going to talk about how you're empowered to control this, because the grace of God, says in Titus 2, 11 and 12, the grace of God, the gospel, the message that you're accepted, you're approved of, and His affection for you that your father could have never gave you, this message of the gospel says it gives you the power to say no to ungodliness. So this is good news. Say it's good news.
Good news.
Yeah, say it like guys, please.